guys. Happy Labor Day. It's September 1st, 2014. I'm Reginald, also known as Dimcad. First, the Ebola virus. Looks like, according to the World Health Organization, as many as 20,000 people may be infected with this virus over the next 6 months. So far, 1,500 people have already died because of this virus. But there's been some big breakthroughs. For example, ZMapp, this drug has been used to actually save the lives of two Americans. And they actually experiment with this drug on several monkeys, or actually 21 monkeys or so, and they actually found a lot of success in that. So that's some good news for people who are actually infected with it. There's actually some hope if they can gain access to ZMapp. Now, they're also going to begin the first human trials of a new drug, a vaccine for humans. Now, this is going to be pretty interesting. It's amazing to see how much of these drugs just come out of nowhere and actually move forward now that this virus has really broken out. It's kind of interesting. This is how humans are. They were very reactionary creatures. Well, speaking of reaction, Russia. There's reports from the Ukrainian defense minister that Russia's threatening nuclear weapons, which sounds a bit over the top. But Russian president, the leader, the number one guy, Vladimir Putin, basically said to European leaders in a report, reportedly said that if he wanted to, he could have his forces take over the capital of Ukraine within 2 weeks. A little interesting comment if he actually said that. It's interesting because at the same time, you have the number two guy, the prime minister guy, basically saying that, the Russian prime minister is saying that, we want a peaceful settlement to the situation in Ukraine. And at this point, it's sort of interesting to see how the two different, from one side you're hearing one thing, from the other side you're hearing another thing. This is how Ukraine's going to really break down. Russia's going to tighten its grip, okay? Western European nations can't do much about it. They're talking about building a 4,000-soldier reactionary force in case Russia actually invades Ukraine or gets aggressive. They're not going to be able to do much of anything, okay? Too much of Western Europe is dependent on Russian natural gas. They're too dependent on Russian natural gas to really be effective in really dealing with Russia. Russia, they cut them off. A lot of European countries are going to be in a bad situation. So not even NATO could really exert enough influence to really stop Russia from doing what it wants to do in Ukraine. While that's going on, we now have President Obama finally getting off his vacation and and going to Estonia to try to calm some fears there. It's a small Eastern European country, and there's a big Russian population there, and people are concerned that Russia may make some moves in Estonia. And of course, people criticize the president of the United States for not really doing much of anything, going on too many vacations. For me, I'm okay with him going on vacations, okay? If he goes on vacations and plays golf for the rest of the rest of his term, I'll be okay with that, okay? I'd rather have him playing golf than actually signing executive orders and signing laws that violate constitutional rights. I'd rather have him off playing golf than having to worry about him doing some real damage. I mean, that's just how I feel at this point. And I don't see the 2014 elections being relevant regardless of whether the Republicans take over or not. Right here in the U.S., what's going on? You basically have the jobless claims selling somewhere around 300,000 new people applying for jobless claims every single week. And those are pretty much the latest numbers. They're sort of hovering around an area. What you got to understand is that there's a lot of people out of the workforce. A lot of people have been removed from the workforce. A lot of people have left pretty much permanently. And that's going to be what really matters in the long term. Also, consumer spending actually went down by 0.1%, which isn't the end of the world at all. I think we're spending too much money. I think there needs to be more saving. There actually was more saving in July. Actually, the savings rate went up to 5.7. It went from 5.4 to 5.7, so that's a little good news. If people are saving more, it may be an indicator that people have more money to really save with. Because it's kind of hard to save when you don't have money to save with. All right, Iraq. There's talk about Iraq, ISA. Take it, this is the Islamic radicals, jihadists, taking over more areas in Iraq. And people are criticizing Obama for pulling out of Iraq. The neocons, of course, doing what they do. Look, we should have never been in Iraq in the first place, okay? We should have left Saddam alone, okay? I'm not saying he was an angel by any stretch of the imagination, but the fact of the matter is he had stability in that country, and when we came in there, we removed him, trying to protect the petrodollar. We created a great deal of instability. Well, once we did that, I thought it would have made more sense for us to allow the different groups within that country that was artificially carved and created by Western interests, including the British. It would have made more sense to allow the Kurds and the Shiite and different groups to form their own little countries in that area, since there was such a different take on what they should do moving forward in the first place. But anyway, they wanted one big country that the United States could control, and they've lost control. They tried to go into Syria, and they lost control. They didn't really get what they wanted in Syria either. All right, last story. I actually came across something that was really interesting. They were talking about how this Texas school district was actually going to allow teachers to carry guns. I thought it was a great idea, because especially if you require them to have training, you know, and you're not publicizing which teachers have guns and which ones don't, you're sort of forcing potential attackers to realize that, hey, if I go into a certain area, I may have to deal with a certain amount of force, so they may choose a different target. It's certainly a lot better than saying, oh, we're not going to do anything, and none of our teachers are allowed to have guns, okay? It's a gun-free zone. We obviously know that doesn't really work out too well. It's interesting because when it comes to money, when it comes to protecting money, people expect you to have guns. Like when you're transporting money from point A to point B, now people expect there to be armed guards. But when you walk into a school and that's where people put their kids, you know, people are completely comfortable with there being no armed guards, no police officers, nobody there to protect them. They're completely comfortable with that. But then when it comes to their money, they're like, oh man, I want like 10 armed guards or something. It's kind of interesting, some interesting dynamic. Anyway, guys, I just want you guys to sort of comment on that and share your thoughts about these issues. This is a Mossberg 500 4N. I'm going to put this on my Mossberg 500. Actually, I had to buy an extension to make the tube longer, so this would actually fit. So I'm going to do a video on that, guys. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.